Hi guys and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to discover how to run World of War Machines on your PC. As you can see now, you are watching it on screen. It takes almost no time to easily download and install World of War Machines and enjoy the game on our Windows desktop or laptop using our keyboard, mouse and large monitor. Then without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else buddies, the first thing to do is to open our main web browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to the current URL I'm highlighting in green. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. There is no need to type the URL, because I provided a clickable link in the video description and the first pinned comment. We arrived at this point on our own website of Usitility, where we include an in-depth overview on the best way to download World of War Machines on computer. We browse lower a tad and simply click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on that link, we arrive here on the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will launch to get access to this game World of War Machines on the PC. It is now obvious that we have some pros of using this emulator. Then, we are on the way to start downloading the World of War Machines by clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green. We then click on it. Of course, the download step takes no time at all. Here it is, this is the download. It is a file to execute. The following step is to run the installer, okay, so we click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow modifications to the device. We have said yes. I reduce the web browser to start to see the installer much better. The installation software is very simple to use. It is made up of two options, install and setup path. I will describe what setup path actually does. We simply just click on it. Therefore, we realize that we display here the path in which the emulator will be placed. If we need to vary this folder, we must click on this Browse button, and now we opt for another directory and install the emulator where we would like. To keep it simple, just leave it where it is. Then, I click on Back. And therefore I just click on Install. Great. The install commences and it will continue along with the download of those MB that happens to be shown on that screen. After you download it, it could be more or less megabytes. The download speed may go faster or at a lower speed, subject to your web access and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator servers. Right away they are running extremely fast. The download is finished, then straight away it proceeds with the installation part. The installation needs a little bit more or less time depending on the power of your computer. The more powerful it's actually, the shorter the setup time and vice versa. If we combine the download and installation phase, it might take a very long time, so have patience. It is now finished on my side. At this point, the emulator has actually been started instantly. As you will notice, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar that will fill up then when it actually reaches the ending, the emulator is launched for the very first time. The reality is the emulator has been started, here it is for the first time. Before we continue on, as now you can see, it created two icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is going to be the one we are interested in. When we would like to run World of War Machines on our PC, we double-click on this app icon and consequently start the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance app icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or nearly anything like this. The truth is, it's an icon that we may most likely never utilize. We should conduct the next phase, which is a must, and which is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. As you will notice, the Google Play is presented. In this case, we need to sign in. At present, once we're here, we must conduct the next phase that is definitely mandatory. Therefore, we click on Sign In. At this point, it announces Checking Info. It might from time to time get stuck in Checking Info, additionally, it doesn't proceed. In that case, you may attempt to log in after a few hours and it will surely most certainly be corrected. At this point, we can type our email and password. The email address needs to be a Gmail email as well as its corresponding password. For instance, you can use the exact same email you are using at this time in your YouTube account. So I am going to enter my details and I'll return immediately after I have accomplished it. That's all, info typed. This is Google welcoming us and offering us their terms of service. We would say yes to them simply by clicking on, I agree. After that, it allows us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can leave it selected and it'll make a backup of the files on this device to Google Drive. I will not select it, you can utilize that feature if you prefer. We simply click on Accept. The Google Play Store is started without need to open it manually and instantly. To install the video game, we must browse the emulator desktop for Android by clicking on that icon marked green colored. Currently that we are discovering the desktop of that emulator, we see that we have now right here the install app option. We click on that button. At this point we come with the Android game. Why don't we click on right here on the install option that I am just presenting now in green. This will launch the software setup. At this moment it will download on your laptop or computer and set up the game app. It can take a while or it could be extremely fast. It again all will depend on the internet connection. It has already finished setting up. Back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking the following button that I am showing in green, to be able to start World of War Machines for the very first time. Shall we click or double click on this My Games option above? I am currently on the emulator desktop, and then we are going to click that fresh World of War Machines software icon that has been generated. That game app is started for the first time on your machine. There we end up with it. I'm able to mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to talk about the sound level of the emulator. It is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This manner we will not rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of your emulator. As well as to appreciate the experience to the greatest, we can turn on the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. That is simply the very first one. We click on this app icon that I am designating in green. Then the display screen is maximized, enjoying one border at the top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. Supposing that we choose to play the game in full screen, we hit this particular application icon. And therefore we would probably without a doubt be enjoying the game in 100% screen setting. To escape the complete screen mode, push the F11 key. And we'd just be in normal display mode. From now, I am on the way to explain you the keyboard mapping which is definitely extremely helpful. That way we may be able to utilize the game application more easily. The first thing is to click on this keyboard icon. And right now there you will have the ability to complete the necessary configurations. I can keep the normal settings, but if you wish to change it, you may very well achieve it with no problem. Clearly, the emulator is fully in our own language. From time to time it happens that your emulator is started in the improper language, such as, in Chinese. So to set it up in the appropriate language we go here to the cogwheel. So right here throughout other settings, we click the language drop down. We may go for the language we need, English, Japanese, etc. When the language is determined, we would save, the emulator would restart, and the game, the next time we use it, will as well be in the specified language. At this time, you can find another point that we must take into account, and this is that we will receive a message from Google telling you that a new machine has been connected to our Google account. It will likely ask us if we are the ones who have connected that device. Yes, we really should not be troubled, as the emulator is behaving like in Google Android electronic device. And then to determine which tablet or smartphone is being emulated, we come right here, to the cogwheel and we simply click on it. So we browse here to the model selection. And here we discover that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for my tutorial. I hope you appreciated it, particularly that everyone thought it was useful. In that case, give it a great thumb up, subscribe to the channel, and any comments, questions or suggestions, leave them in the comment area down below. You also can comment things on my Twitch channel, I actually do live streams every once in a while, you get it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Just click on any of those online videos that happens to be showing up on the suggestion of videos to watch and see you in the upcoming video tutorials. Bye.